Hello, ghost hunters. Do you keep track of your sanity? Do you even know which things lower your sanity? Do you worry about it? Do you know what makes this happen? Stay tuned for all things sanity. The van is equipped with a sanity tracker. It shows the current sanity of all players in your game. The information on the board isn't exact and changes constantly. This information updates regularly and can vary by 3 above or 3 below your actual sanity. This is why you will see a player with 0 sanity suddenly have 3%. They haven't really gained any sanity. As I just mentioned, you never gain sanity. The only way to gain sanity currently is through sanity pills. Sanity pills will restore approximately 40% sanity, and you can bring 4 pills per hunt. There are 2 types of sanity drains, passive and active. Passive sanity drain is unavoidable and part of the game. Every location will have passive sanity drain that begins the moment you enter the location. Smaller locations drain your sanity faster than larger locations. Harder difficulties will also drain your sanity faster. But never fear, for those of you playing solo, sanity drains slower if you're playing alone. Active sanity drain is where things get interesting. If you've witnessed a ghost event or a scare event, you will lose sanity. This varies a bit, but appears to be somewhere between about 5 to 10%. If you use a Ouija board, you will have a dip in sanity as well. Each successful response deducts somewhere between 5 and 10% sanity. The game has visual clues to warn players that they have had a significant drop in sanity by flickering the lights on the board. If this happens, you've likely lost about 40% sanity. But what if you aren't messing with the Ouija board at all? Sanity passively drains, and as your sanity drains, chances of ghost activity will increase. Remember, those scare events will drop your sanity even more. The lower your sanity, the more likely the ghost is to hunt you. This is why it's so important to keep your sanity high. 0 sanity doesn't guarantee a hunt, just as high sanity doesn't guarantee the ghost won't hunt. You should know that if you are playing professional, the moment you walk in the door, the ghost can technically hunt you. It is extremely unlikely that will happen, but it is possible. Let's talk about testing. There's a lot of conflicting information about sanity and how it affects your game. So I put a few things to the test to figure out what is true and what is fiction. Lower level players lose sanity faster than high level players. False. A sub-level 10 player and a player with several hundred levels both entered the same location, hid in the dark for the same amount of time, and both emerged with the same amount of sanity. Neither player was more affected than the other. Strong flashlight will keep your sanity higher than a weak flashlight. False. Sending 2 players into a location to hide in the dark, one with a weak flashlight and one with a strong flashlight, both returned with the same amount of sanity. So it doesn't matter if you use a strong flashlight or a weak flashlight. 0 sanity means a player will die. False. If your sanity dips to 0, the ghost is more likely to hunt or be more active, but you will not die. In fact, there's often a daily challenge to reach 0% sanity. The player with the lowest sanity will be the ghost's target. False. If you've not watched my video on how to survive the hunt, you should. I cover a lot of information on how the ghost hunts as well. Because of the string theory and the banshee's hunting style, this is definitely not true. You are no safer during a hunt than your teammates with lower sanity. Only the sanity of players inside the location determine if the ghost will hunt. Undetermined. Because a ghost can hunt as soon as the timer is up in the van or unprofessional, the moment you enter the building, there is no way to determine if this is true or not. Some ghosts hunt early and more frequently than others, thus it's not possible to determine which is true. My personal belief is that the average sanity of the entire team is considered, rather than just those players inside the location. Sanity cannot drop below 50% during setup. False. This was probably the most interesting test I did for this whole video. Your sanity can dip below 50% at any time. My team and I entered smaller locations, grabbed a Ouija board, and then started asking the ghost questions, and something I didn't know was possible happened. Asking the ghost questions angered it and then immediately ended the timer. If you force your sanity below 50%, the timer will end immediately. I tested this multiple times and it was true every single time. So don't use that Ouija board during your setup time unless you're ready for the ghost to start hunting. Responses from the Ouija board drop your sanity 5 to 10%. True. If the light on the Ouija board flickers though, you've taken a significant hit, typically 40%. But successful questions will only drop you from 5 to 10%. And for some of my tests to see how sanity worked, first, if two players hide together but only one has a flashlight, does the one without the flashlight lose more sanity? The answer is no. Both players lose sanity at the same rate. Because of this, we determined that it was possible that having a flashlight at all does not affect sanity. So we tried ghost hunting without flashlights, which, by the way, is very difficult. And to our surprise, having a flashlight at all does not make a difference. Second, the game would have us believe that staying in the light makes you the ghost target. In fact, it's a tip the game offers when loading in. But is this true? Well, no. Ghosts target players based on who is visible and closest to them. Banshees are the only ghosts that vary from this and target only one person until that person has died. So, does staying in the light make the Banshee target you? Maybe, but it seems very unlikely. Keywords do not lower your sanity. You can say anything you want in any part of the location, and it will not affect your sanity. Keep in mind though that they might anger the ghost and thus trigger hunts or scare events, both of which will lower your sanity. Your tools, like the spirit box or the EMF making noise to indicate interactions with the ghost, do not lower your sanity. Ouija boards affect the player asking the question. My team and I tested having one player turning on the Ouija board and another asking a question. The player who asked the question was the only player to take a hit to sanity. Just keep in mind that the Ouija board works via voice recognition. So if you have an active board in your room, you may want to be careful about what you say lest it thinks you're asking it a question. And finally, candles. How do candles factor into sanity? Well, some of you may think they're just for lighting, but they're not. Holding a candle will prevent sanity loss. Therefore, using a candle in place of a flashlight might actually make you safer. I tested sending players into a location with candles or standing near candles that were lit in a location, and both times players took no sanity loss. Candles can be used to light other candles or smudge sticks. The only downside is that sometimes candles do go out. I'm uncertain if this is because the ghost blows them out or if they just burn out over time. They do seem to stay lit when I have higher sanity, so it could very well be the ghost blowing them out. But if you want to keep your sanity high, candles are your friend. If you have any questions or thoughts about sanity, please leave them in the comments below. If you have topics or questions you'd like me to cover, let me know. I love hearing from fellow ghost hunters. Thanks for watching. Remember to like and subscribe, and happy hunting.